my own little world, it hardly ever rains. I've never gone hungry, always felt safe. I got some money in my pocket, shoes on my feet. In my own little world, population, me. What if there's a bigger picture? What if I'm missing out? What if there's a greater purpose? I could be living right now. Outside my own little world.
Poverty is the principal cause of hunger in Africa. People who live there don't have enough money to buy enough food to even support life. About 47% of the population live solely on $1.25 or less a day. Things as simple as getting a drink of water turns into an all-day event. Their hunger is hunger that we have never experienced. When Janie Berry, who is now the owner of the Potter's House in Marion, Indiana, went to Africa, she experienced the reality of hunger.
You know, most of the time that we were there, we were hungry. It didn't matter that we had money, we had a vehicle to go get food, where we were, those things didn't matter because if there's no food,
stores such as the Potter's House in Marion support these people. This business goes through the fair trade system, which sends the money straight to the poverty-stricken communities of Africa. The people in these communities make products such as scarves and drums, but usually get little to no money in return. Living in Africa and having no say in the matter leaves them voiceless to communities such as ours. We take advantage of them, and they can't do anything about it. Fair trade does more, however, than just distribute the money where it belongs. It also frees children and women of slave labor. Slavery in the cocoa industry is big, but nobody ever talks about it. The children who are trafficked by their own parents have no voice. Some live the life of a slave until they grow old. These children work in horrible conditions, given the most inexpensive food, sleeping on wooden planks, living in dungeon cells, and being beaten and whipped as part of their daily routine. Dursa, a man from Africa, illustrated this when he said, "When people eat chocolate made from slave labor, they're eating my own flesh." When you eat Hershey's chocolate, you're eating the chocolate that these children slaved over. Child slavery is proof of the poverty in Africa. If parents are willing to send their own kids off to slave owners because they're that desperate for money, then there's something wrong. Buying chocolate from places such as the Potter's House, where they get cocoa through fair trade, will decrease this slavery. Cocoa that comes through fair trade has not been slaved over. Rather, it was properly and legally worked for. There is a greater picture outside our own little world. Africans living in poverty don't have the safety of assured life like we do.